So in the introduction of Java, we will see that a different language that is called object-oriented programming or OOP. So OOP is that object-oriented programming. So you need to know what is the difference between the object-oriented programming and with our procedural language like C. In object-oriented programming, the whole code, that is the code part where we are writing the code, and the data part, that data we are using, that data, the code is modify the data. So data is, if the value of A is 5, and in the code I am writing that A equals to A plus 5. So basically the data part is A equals to 5, and in the code part we are actually modify the data using some of the logic. So the if we just combine these two things, that is code plus data, we are forming the object. So this is a overview of an object. In the procedural language like C, the C is a procedural language. In the procedural language C, what we have seen, the code and data are in separate manner. So this is your code and this is your data, and the code and data are completely separate. But in object oriented programming, if we are talking about the object, then the code and data, it can bind together. Now we will see why Java and what is the importance of Java. Now if we are talking about Java, the first thing is come to our mind, that is, it is platform independent. It is platform independent. So what is the meaning of this platform independentness? So basically, if we are talking about some different operating system or platform, so our platform may be the Windows platform, it can be a Macintosh, or it can be a Linux platform. Suppose we are writing the code in Windows, and if we execute the code in Windows, then our native code will be generated after compilation. So if we take this native code to this Mac or Linux, then this native code will work for Macintosh and Linux also. But initially we have make this native code in Windows platform, but still this native code will work for the Linux as well as Macintosh platform. So this is we talking about the platform independentness. It does not depend upon what is the platform you are using, but it will work for all the platforms. But how it can possible in Java? So you need to know about the internal representation of Java. So in internally, if we are talking about the JDK, so JDK is a popular Java development kit. The full form is Java Development Kit. So in Java development kit is mostly used for interactive application that we are using in daily basis. Now in JDK, the JRE is there, that is the runtime environment for JDK. So whatever we are running the program in Java, we are going to run the program. So JRE, that is the Java runtime environment, gives you resources for running the program. Okay, now this is JRE. In JRE, different libraries are there, and those libraries are activate whenever we execute our program. and it will create the native code. So, and that is we can execute our program. So that's why we often say that the Java program can be compiled once and it can be run many times. So one popular phrase for Java, that is compile once and run everywhere. So this was the basic of Java. In Java you need to first know something, that is it is an object oriented programming language. And what is an object? Object is nothing but a combination of code and data. After that we learn that is in Java there is a setup of JVM. So JVM is a Java development kit which is used to make interactive application using Java program. And if we see the internal representation of JDK, we see jQuery is there and others libraries and Java C, that is the compiler, is there. And if we talking about the jQuery, in jQuery the most thing is the JVM and other libraries are there which is helpful for runtime, for running the application in JVM. This is the key factor, and the JVM gives the Java as platform independentness. This platform independentness is mainly for JVM. So we have seen how the JVM makes the Java as platform independentness, and this is a very popular question. If this question is asked many times in your university examination as well as in the campusing examination. Thank you.